What about 2011? It's not yet ready.
Not yet ready, sir.
Okay. So all of these allowances listed in Exhibit 114 from 2002 to 2010, even 2011, were not subject to withholding tax, except those year-end and cash bonus in excess of 30,000. Is that correct?
Yes, Your Honor.
Is that, please? Can you speak louder? Yes?
Yes, Your Honor.
All right. And it was not, according to you, subject to withholding tax because they were expenses which were supposed to have been liquidated in the payroll. Hindi ba?
Ever since I...
Just answer the question. They were not subject to any withholding tax. I mean, these bonuses in excess of up to 30,000 and all of these other emoluments were not subject to withholding tax and were not reported as income because they were all reimbursable expenses as appearing in the certification in the payroll.
Hindi ko po sinabing reimbursable ang mga allowances na tinatanggap ng Supreme Court.
But they are not income in your classification?
They are income po.
They are income. But they are not taxable.
Ayun po ang usual practice ng court na lahat pong allowances na tinatanggap namin are not subject to tax.
I see. So, hindi, not subject to tax. Now, when you were asked extensively on that certification, you said the certification appeared in the as appearing in the payroll. Hindi ba?
Yes, Your Honor.
Do you recall exactly what appears there? Is it the following amounts are being are certified to have been spent by the recipient or substantially to that effect? Is that how it looks?
Hindi po, Your Honor.
What appears there?
The monthly allowance, then the monthly received by the recipient, then they sign the payroll. Ayun po ang aming inililiquidate sa COA.
Ah, there is a sheet of paper which appears like a payroll, the amounts of allowances and other emoluments appearing there are signed by the recipient and this serves as the liquidation of those amounts. Ganun po ba?
Opo.
Ayun. So wala na pong resibong binibigay, basta pinipirmahan na lang doon sa payroll and that is deemed to be the liquidation.
Opo, Your Honor.
I see. Kaya hindi po sinasama yan sa income for purposes of withholding taxes. Hindi po ba?
Nadatnan ko na po na yung...
No, yun po ang prinsipyo nun.
Sagutin mo lang yung question.
Hindi po sinasama yan sa withholding tax computation dahilan sa yan ay sa inyong reglamento, sa inyong practice, yan po ay expense na na-incur, hindi po income.
I will ask the question, no? Madam Witness, yung mga hindi regular salary ay hindi isinasama sa subject to withholding tax. Sangayon sa treatment ng accounting procedure ng Korte Suprema, ganun ba?
Yes, Your Honor.
Are you?
So that halimbawa lamang, looking at your exhibit 117, exhibit 117, for the year 2010, for the Chief Justice, the total amount of income or emoluments, I withdraw the word income, emoluments, is 2,082,682.38. Tama po ba yun?
Yes, Your Honor.
Yung withholding tax saan binase? Sa salary, 650,447.23.
Sa salaries po, longevity pay, and
salary?
Salaries, longevity pay.
Longevity pay.
Year-end bonus in excess of 30,000.
Year-end bonus in excess of 30,000. Alin pa? Doon lang.
Doon lang po, Your Honor.
Doon lang. Doon sa iba, walang income tax na binayad sa ibang item.
Yes, Your Honor.
So magkano lang po yung tatlong item na yan na sinabi mo? Salary, longevity pay, and year-end bonus and cash gift.
Habang pinag-aaralan niya, 1 minute suspension.
All right, this is the first suspension of day 29 of the impeachment trial. With Ms. Bayuga still at the witness stand, Senator Franklin Drilon asking clarificatory questions. Dean, where do you think is Senator Drilon going by asking which was, where was withholding tax, which part? Ano, saan papunta to, sir?
I think what the good senator wants to prove is that of the income, no, or of the money received by the Chief Justice of the Supreme Court, no, there are two components. The salary, the income, no? Salary which is subject to income tax, and the allowances.
Okay.
His point is that the allowances, no, are there for specific purposes. They're supposed to cover expenses, no, of the Office of the Chief Justice. So they should not form part of the income, and therefore they cannot be used for any purpose other than the purposes indicated, no, by law.
Because the defense had earlier presented that from 2002 to 2011 or 2010, there was a total income of 21.6 million to help explain the amount that was presumably found in the bank accounts. So in layman's terms, Dean, anong ibig sabihin po nito? Yung buong 21.6, hindi po yun yung buong amount or hindi po dapat ibilang yun?
Lahat yun natanggap ni Chief Justice, no? Pero hindi lahat yun ay income. Ang kalakihan daw noon, according to the line of questioning of the senator, no, good senator, dapat daw gamitin sa purposes ng Office ng Chief Justice.
Yung sinabing 21.6 million based sa binanggit, which was